Hello students, hope you all are doing well. I am back with another video in which we are going to do addition of rational numbers. In this video, we will going to study that how we have to add rational numbers. As you all know that rational numbers are the numbers which are in the form of p upon q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. That is, the denominator is not equal to 0. When we add two rational numbers or more than two rational numbers, two cases arises. Case one is in which the denominator is same. Case one is that case in which the denominator is same. So let us take one example, general example, like p upon q and r upon q. As you can see, in this p upon q, denominator is q, and in the rational number r upon q, denominator is q. In general, whenever you have to add rational numbers, keep one thing in mind that you have to make the denominator same. This is the rule. Keep this thing in mind always that you have to make the denominator same. And in our case 1, the denominators are same already. It is given to us that the denominators are same. So what we have to do? We have to simply write the same denominator and we have to add the terms present in numerator. So this will be our answer when we will add two rational numbers having same denominator. Let us understand with an example. Let us add 2 upon 5 and 6 upon 5. As I have told you, our rule is to make the denominator same. But in this question, the denominator is same already. So we just have to simply write the denominator and we have to add the terms present in numerator. So the terms are 2 and 6, 2 plus 6 is 8, and your answer will be 8 upon 5. Let us take one more example, 7 upon 6 and 11 upon 6. Our rule is to make the denominator same, but in this question the denominator is same already. So we will simply write the denominator and add the terms present in numerator. 7 plus 11 is 18, and we will get the answer 18 plus upon 6. And if we will reduce, we have to reduce it in the simplest form. So 6 ones are 6 and 6 threes are 18. So your answer is 3 upon 1. Now what if, as you know that rational numbers are those numbers which are expressed in this form, and p and q both are integers. So as you can see in this minus 3 is a negative integer. So now I have to these two rational numbers. The denominator is same already. We will simply write the denominator 8. Now I have to add these two rational numbers, or I have to add the terms present in numerator. So 8 plus. But the second term is minus 3, so I'll write like this. Now the rule, plus minus, minus. So 8 minus 3 upon 13. 8 minus 3 is 5. So you will get 5 upon 13. This is your answer. Similarly, if I have to add minus 4 upon 9 and 8 upon 9. Again, the denominator is same, so I'll write the first term of the numerator, that is minus 4 and plus 8. Again, plus minus is minus. It means I have to subtract 4 from 8. 8 minus 4 is 4, and the sign of greater digit. Greater digit is 8 and it is having positive sign. So my answer is 4 upon 9. Let us take one more example, minus 11 upon 17 and minus 13 upon 17. Again, the denominator is same. So we have to add the terms present in numerator. Minus 11 plus minus 13, because first term in numerator is minus 11 and we have to add the terms, and second term is minus 13. Plus minus minus, so it will be minus 11 minus 13 upon 17. But minus minus is plus, that is you have to add 11 and 13, but the sign with their answer will be of negative, that is of minus. So 11 plus 13 is 24, but sign is minus minus 24 upon 17. This will be your answer. Let us take one more example. 7 upon 6 and minus 11 upon 6. Again, the denominator is same. We have to add the terms present in numerator. 7 plus, second term is minus 11. Plus minus, minus 7 minus 11 upon 6. Again, plus minus is minus, as 7 is having positive sign. So we have to subtract 7 from 11, that is 11 minus 7, 4. But the sign of greater digit is 11 and it is having negative sign. So it will be minus 4 upon 6. When you will reduce it to the lowest term, 2 2s are 4 and 2 3s are 6. So your answer will be minus 2 upon 3. I hope the addition of rational numbers with same denominator is clear to you now. Practice more questions from your book. Thank you.